Hey guys, Matt here from MK-SmartHouse.com, and in this video I'm going to show you the OpenHAB 2 configuration files as well as how to set them up. The configuration files make up the whole smart home, and without them it would not work, because with these files we create the things which connect to the items that we can use in the sitemaps to create the rules for automation. The statement that I just made is exactly how it works, because there are four main configuration files: things, items, sitemaps, and rules. To access all these files, we have to SSH into the device. So on Windows, open up PuTTY, and on Mac, open up Terminal. If you don't know how to SSH, then you can refer to my Setting Up the Home Automation Server series that will be linked below or in a card at the top right. Speaking of links, I recommend having the written guide on my website open up. So all you have to do is copy and paste commands. Anyway, the folders for where we are going to create these files are located in the OpenHAB 2 folder. So type in cd space forward slash etc forward slash OpenHAB 2 and press enter. To see all the folders in this folder, type in ls and press enter. As you can see, there are many folders and they all do different things. But the first folder we're going to access is the things folder. So type in cd space things and press enter. Then we're going to create the things file. So type in sudo space nano space home.things and press enter. It should open an empty text document. So make a comment, type in forward slash this space is space the space things space file. Then press control X, then Y, and then enter. Great. We created our first configuration file. Eventually, we will populate this file with devices that require a thing declaration. Keep in mind that not all devices need it. The next file we're going to create is the items file. So type in cd period period and press enter to go back to the main folder. Then type in cd space items and press enter. Then type in sudo space nano space home.items. It should open up a text document. The items file is where we're going to create or add all of our devices so they can be accessed, such as a light switch. Type in forward slash this space is space the space items space file and press enter 2 times. But we are not done yet. I think this is a good time to show you one of the most important types of items, and that is a switch. It is not the only type of item. For a complete list, check out the documentation at docs.openhab.org. Anyway, the first item is a switch. So first type in a comment explaining the next item we will create for reference purposes. I wrote forward slash demo space items and pressed enter. Then type in switch space demo sw space quotation mark demo space switch end quotation mark. And press enter. Let me explain what we wrote. The first part is the type of item. The second part is the name, and the third part is its label text. There are many more parts to an item, such as its binding config, but we will get to that when we add an actual device. Now press Ctrl X, then Y, and enter. Then type in cd period period, and press enter to go back to the main folder. Next, type in cd space sitemaps. And press enter. Then type in sudo space nano space home.sitemap and press enter. It should open up a blank text document. The sitemap file is how you interact with the devices or the user interface. Then type in the following code segment that's on the screen now. Then press Ctrl X, then Y, and enter. Now comes the fun part. We're going to see what we created. Keep your SSH window up because we will access it later. Open up your web browser and go to the OpenHAB web user interface. If you don't know how to do that, then look at my video on OpenHAB 2 web interfaces explanation, link in the card or in the description. Then go to Paper UI. In the left column, go to Configuration and then Services subtab. Now we can configure the user interfaces. The first one is Basic UI, so click its Configure button. In the default sitemap field, change whatever is there to Home and press Save. Do the same thing to Classic UI. Click Configure, change the sitemap to Home, and press Save. Great. Now go back to the main web interface screen by typing in the IP address of the Pi again with colon 8080. and click on Basic UI. You should see a switch and the text Demo switch. It does not do anything, but now you understand the process of creating it. We can now also access Classic UI, and it will have the same information as Basic UI. It just looks a little different. Now let's go back to the SSH window and let me explain what each piece of code does. Type in sudo space nano space home.sitemap and press enter. The line sitemap space home space label equals quotation MK-SmartHouse quotation creates a label in the top. Frame space label equals quotation demo creates a new section or box in the interface with the name demo. Switch space item equals demo SW brings the switch item to the user interface so we can control it. Essentially, you can keep creating more frames to organize your system. This is what I like to do. I create a new frame for every room in the house that I will have smart devices. Here's my sitemap file I will be using. If you do use it, then delete everything you have in your sitemap file and then paste it in. Then press Ctrl X, then Y, and enter. I put the demo switch in every frame because a frame cannot be empty, and they are just placeholders till we put in actual devices. Now if you go back to the basic UI, you can see how it all looks. Now let's talk a little about the rules file. This is the file that does all the automation, and since it has so many different things, I will show you how to utilize it in its own video once we add some devices. But in this video, I will show you how to create the file. So type in cd dot dot and press enter to go back to the main folder. Then type in cd space rules and press enter. Then we are going to create the file by typing in sudo space nano space home dot rules and press enter. It should create a text document. Then type in / this space is space the space rules space file. Then press Ctrl X, then Y, and enter. Type in sudo space reboot and press enter to reboot the device. I always recommend rebooting after making major changes like these. That's it. The configuration files are all set up. Now we have the automation server ready for devices to be added. But before we do that, the next two videos will cover how to set up remote access so you can access your smart home from anywhere and control devices from anywhere, which perfectly leads into the video after that, setting up mobile devices to access the home automation server from iOS and Android. All right, thank you for watching, and if you have any questions, leave them in the comments section below or head over to the mksmarthouse.com/forum where you have a better chance of it getting answered. Goodbye.